All right, guys, welcome back. Scrode here, coming at you with another episode of From the Depths. So I had a little bit of a mishap. After I finished recording episode 4, I hopped into the vehicle designer and went about creating a new vehicle. I'm going to go and show it to you guys here. But the episode, I'm using Shadowplay to record, and it just recorded a blank screen the whole time. So I had a bunch of audio and nothing to use with it. So I'm just recording it all again, but we're not going to design the vehicle, sadly. We're just going to load it in here, and then we're going to give it a whirl in the campaign mode. So here we go. I called it the Tasty Delight. It is 69,000 RP. It's really not that bad. Let's load her up. Here's what it is. It's got a few problems. It's kind of a goofy looking ship. Here's Captain's Quarters up here, as you can see. It's beautiful. I mean, if you're going to build a ship, give yourself a super swell view, you know? Of course, in the front, we have a very exposed battery of missiles. Quite intense. Now, what I couldn't get working was this back battery of missiles. So, they're both hooked up to the same mainframe. As you can see here, if we look inside the ship floating about all crazily, we've got our basic AI, target prioritization. Here's the mainframe, and it's connected back here to, you can see here, AI local weapon controller. I don't know if I need to have these on like separate controllers to make them work. Let me go to build mode so I'm not like wishy-washing all over the place thanks to the ocean. I don't know. These, for all intents and purposes, these are hooked up. Everything is hooked up and good. Maybe I can put these on, a different key perhaps, like four? Let's try four. Okay, so four, current slot four. Whoops. And then let me look at the front of the ship. Let's look at this missile battery. And this one is... that's not the right thing. Where is it? No, this is it. Yeah. Should be okay. Oh, wait a sec. Missile. Okay, here's the identify friend or foe. Staggered fire. Local weapon controller. Here's my missile controller. I'm gonna put this on slot 5. Let's try that. Let's get on over there. Ah, here we go. Okay, sweet. So that's what it took. Haha, okay, wow. 34 missiles is the alpha strike. I'm gonna hop into the old captain's chair here. Have a sit, you know? Just be chilling. Grumblebot, chilling over here. Okay, let's give it a whirl. Let's see what the shooting looks like. So, essentially, on the back here, they're shorter missiles, and they have a one-turn mechanism. The front missiles do not have a one-turn. They kind of go... I almost want them to have a one-turn, to be honest. Yeah, you know what? I do. I want them to have a one-turn. I gave them two sets of fins, but for now, they're gonna have a one-turn as well. Alright, let's try. And one turn's great because wherever you are facing your camera when you shoot is sort of where the missiles will try to go. The back ones are on a stagger fire. And in fact, I kind of want these to be staggered as well. In fact, now that I'm thinking about that, I better make sure and put... let's see, where is it? La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. Identify friend or foe. Absolutely. Gotta have one of those. Okay, good. And I also want staggered fire. Right there. Look at that. 0.3 delay. Perfect. Okay. Guys, we're ready. Here we go. Let's test it out. Okay, let me save real quick before I do this, now that I've made the modifications. Taste of Delight will now be version 3. Alright, test of the Alpha Strike. Here we go. Alright, let's give it a try. Oh, wait a minute. Look. It happened. I lost control of the back ones all of a sudden. I swear, I just had access to those. Did putting this on here... Am I too far away, perhaps? Let me look. I might actually be too far away. That could be the problem. Get out of the chair. Ah, that's the problem. This is the only place I can stand to get control of both. Okay. Oh, that sucks. Really? Oh man, that's kind of rough. Maybe that's because that's where the mainframe is. Damn, I don't want the chair to be like in some goofy spot. Can I still control the ship from here? Yeah, okay, I still can. From here. Here's where I have access to both missile controllers. Let's just try it from here. Here we go. Oh, yeah, look at this. Beautiful. Okay, let's see how much of our resources it takes to reload. You can see our ammo count, we can hold 4,600 on this bad boy. It's really meant to hit hard with this first Alpha Strike, to be honest. Okay, you know what? I'm going to try to put some more ammo barrels, because why not? In a world where ammo barrels are all that matter, Scroat doesn't know how to say no. More ammo barrels? I mean, look at all this space for ammo barrels. I tell you what, though. Somebody just has to land, like, one hit in this inner area, and it is flipping game over, man. Okay, now we've got 7,600 ammo. I essentially just want to get in there and be like, you're all dead. You're goodbye, everybody. It's been a sweet life. That put us up to 74,000 RP. That's not really a bad increase when you think about it. We're looking at 18,000 resources, 11,000 metal, 1,200 oil, 7,200 scrap, and almost no crystal. You know what? Let's also put some repair tentacles on here. Miscellaneous, repair tentacle. Now, which one repairs my own boat, I wonder? We're going to go with this one. I think this is the one you use on your boat to, like, repair stuff. I'm just going to lace the sides with these. Let's see. Turn on. Nope, I went wrong there. Text message. Great. I don't know if you heard that. Just got a text. Okay, here we go. Mirror mode's on. I'm just going to pop some of these. Like, this might be a silly place. Actually, got to put a few more wood blocks down here. That do it? Do we seal up? Oh. Perfect. Okay, and let's see. Alright. Now we can probably place these down. No, that doesn't seem right. Does that seem like the right kind of repair bot? Is that correct? Oh no, here it is. Repair bot. Ah! This is what I want. I'm ridiculous. I almost put the wrong thing down. Wow, those are expensive. Okay, so are these. These repair bots alone probably jacked it. Yes, okay, another 4,000. All right, now we're good. Save. Save over the tasty delight. So here it is. Yeah, this is our ship. It's not the fastest ship, around, I guess. Let's go ahead and take this chair out, because obviously this doesn't work right here. And that totally sucks. In fact, we're going to make some quick modifications to this little area right here. You gotta travel in style, that's the thing. Like, I'm just going to extend this out a little bit. Find the right spot for the chair so you can control both missiles. Okay, cool. That looks pretty cool. Here we go. Let's get some more glass blocks here. Actually, some more wood blocks to finish our drawing on the sides. Okay. And we're gonna do that. You can see I'm not the best designer in the world. Whoops. So I've got this other weird problem, by the way. You know how you can normally press G to align your block with the camera? Otherwise it, like, follows your mouse? Mine is stuck. Like, I'm pressing G. I can only get this to rotate where the direction of the block is going to be by pressing G now. It's like I got bamboozled somehow. I'm stuck in bamboozled mode. It's just life throwing not very tasty lemons at me, I guess. That looks a little weird. That's okay. And let's put some glass right right here, maybe? Yeah, yeah, okay. Looks a little funky, but we're gonna doing it in real time. We're gonna pop the door right here. Oh yeah, it's coming together. One standard door, please. Perfect. I'm liking it. All right, let me get, okay, my guy's in the right spot for controlling both of the weapons. So let's get the vehicle controller. We're gonna place it like here. Mm-hmm. And then we're gonna get the chair. Gotta have a chair. I got it. It'd be sweet if you could build some really badass looking chairs. In fact, like usual, I like to put my chair on a wood block, raised up just a bit, so you've got the grand captain's view. And you're ready! Oh man, you're ready! We gotta open up. Open this up just a bit here. These glass blocks are definitely gonna be worthless for deflecting any incoming enemy fire. But that is okay. I'm taking a few of these off because I noticed like my guy's head just sort of clips through just a bit. There we go. Beautiful! Yay! Okay, so, oh, look at this. This is great. Let's have a sit. Here we are in the Grand Captain's chair. All right, crank her up, Cletus. We're moving at a solid 4 meters a second, so I think I can make that faster. So originally I tried a big, huge boat propeller, and it was actually too much. It was too much awesome coming at me at once. One here. One here. Perfect. Okay, so those may not always be under the water, but that's okay. Alright, here we go. Let's crank it up, see how much power we use. Let's see how fast we can get going. 4.8. Give it a turn. It's so cool when you're just sitting up here, just kind of cruising around. Okay, I think it's ready. Let's do a little launch here. Oh no! I'm too far back. I'm too high up. I can only shoot one of my barrages of missiles. Ah, oh, damn. Right, it's always something. Okay. Well, maybe I can't have this on a chair. Yep, I think that's... I mean, on a wood block. Damn. It's alright. It's alright. We'll just put a chair in there. It's not going to be the most elegant captain's solution ever. There's one loose chair. Sit in the chair. Okay, now we have full control. As long as I keep turning my camera, I can keep directing the missiles to, hell, almost do a full 180. Do a 360 and land right back in your missile pods. Okay, let's save it and let's give this a whirl. Let's see if we can spawn this in. Alright, back to the main menu. Here we go. I'm totally stoked. Single player, let's load it up. So as you know, in the last episode 4... I got my first taste of utter defeat. I mean, you know, I really got wrecked. It was such a huge bummer. So, and yeah, this is where the reckoning happened. So apparently I'm still getting resources. We have a slew of resources, I think. Let's spawn in the fortress. See the weird problem I have? I can't spawn. I'm clicking it, but I can't spawn it in. Am I still within the... Yeah. I'm still good. So once I... Now I can. It's kind of strange. I don't know if that's a bug. Like, you have to come down into the world once before you can, you know, actually spawn the ships in. I'm just going to leave it on the ground. It's cool. It's fine. I have a feeling there's some other controller I probably need, which would keep my fortress off the ground. Maybe one of those, like, complex controllers. I am by means no master of the systems here. Okay, here we go. Perfect. So what I want to do is spawn in. I think I have enough to spawn one of these tasty delights. Yeah, we totally do. Let's do it. Let's get one. Here we go. All right, crazy straws, do your thing. Here we go. Excellent. One tasty delight. This is probably the biggest ship I've built. It's just as vulnerable, which I hate. I've noticed a lot of the starting ships, like the ones you fight with the factions, they don't have a lot of fallback weapon systems, you know? It's like, as long as you take out their primary, you're good. It's the bigger ones that I'm worried about, because they have multiple weapon systems, and sometimes I've noticed even multiple sets of AI. So you may take one part out, but the rest of the ship is going to be working just fine. I mean, it's going to be working just fine. Let's go ahead and turn on the old natural scrapper. Get some scrap going. I hope I spawn this far enough out. Oh, I'm excited. I'm excited to take this boat out. All right, so while that's going, let me figure out what I was doing here. Utter defeat. Oh, and see this... Oh, no, he's moving down here. No, intercept course. Let's fall back a few squares here. I got a little overzealous, overambitious, if you will, taking over some spots that I just couldn't defend when they sent the real fleet. I thought he might have been moving. Oh, it's this guy. This guy. Yeah, he was originally a force count of 7 with a strength of 30. I only took it down by 1. That's pretty horrible. We'll go ahead and pull all and just speed it up a little bit. Let the spawning over here happen as well. Wow, my ships are barely moving. Jeez. That is, like, agonizing slow. Look at how slow they are. What happened? They actually may be out of fuel. Could be why they're moving so slow. Which, I guess it'd be weird if they were moving at all, if they were actually out of fuel. Let's go down and look. Now, this guy's good. He's still got... I'm apparently repairing it, but he's still got a ton of fuel. Let's see. Deep, deep, deep down in the depths. Randy Newman! How did you get down here? This one may have been damaged already. He was up there. So, they've got a fleet coming to one of the squares I already took over. Also, a very sizable fleet. Oi! Alright, let's go check out. Let's check this bad boy out. And let's get the Tasty Delight in. Oh, well, that's not good. That totally stopped repairing it and everything. I forgot what happens when you pull all. Okay, well, we'll just have to let this happen el natch. Got the missiles coming in. You can see when I first started this design, I was cracking up because it looks like an upvote arrow or like a mushroom is the design of the ship. It's ugly. It's ugly as molasses. And yeah, one of the things I got, obviously, I lost all sorts of stuff when my video didn't record right, but with this design, like, I guess there's, for me, two different mindsets when you're coming up with a design. One is you've already got a design in your head, so you can start making that design from the get-go, and you can put your components into that design to make it fit. And the other one was how I built this, is I have no design in my head. What I did was I started with just a blank surface, built an engine, put a few parts around it, and then I built my weapon systems on the surface. In fact, as how it's building up, really, is kind of how I put it together, sans all the ammo barrels. And then you kind of, you know, build the outside design around it. I think you get much worse designs that way in most cases, at least for me, mainly because I don't know what I'm doing half the time when I'm building stuff. I just sort of throw blocks down, which is the beauty of this game. Just throw some blocks down. Look at these missiles. I mean, Jesus. They're freaking amazing looking. Nom nom nom. Maybe not so much, but I'm ready. I'm ready. Let's take a look at the map again. So once this guy's done spawning in, I'm going to send him out, intercept this guy. I don't want to lose this resource zone. Oh yeah, and you know, and something else I was thinking of, the other kind of ship I want to build is a ramming ship, just with like all the ramming attachments on the front and sides. I want to make it super fast. I'm thinking some sort of ship that has like jet engines, but still stays in the water. You know, something that flies really fast and just rams the shit out of stuff. That may be the next task or video I try to record. I'm going to try again, by the way, to record me designing something. I was so bummed. It was like a 40-minute episode I had, just putting this thing together, you know, just talking about the building mode and stuff. It was pretty great. Here we go. All that's left really is the captain's top here and some of the side attachments. I also don't have a air pump in here. Sometimes I wonder if that matters. I'm going to pop one in there while it's building. The air pump keeps, you know, the water out of your internal holds. Maybe. Can I put one down right now? It might not let me while the ship's spawning in. Or actually, there's going to be stuff spawning in right there, I bet. Let me just sneak over here, maybe, where nobody's around. Here we go! Perfect! We should see the water decrease in here. Yeah, see? No more water up in the in our ship. This is great. Oh, it's moving. What are you doing? No. Keep preparing, please. Keep building up. Oh god, it's moving on its own. Let's get over there. Get out of the chair, Grundle. Get over there, Grundle. Oh my god. Okay, I'm in the chair. Stop. Whew. Or I'm near the chair, at least. Perfect. Okay, stop. Reverse. Stop. Full on, stop. How am I doing? Are we all repaired up? I think we might be. Okay, yeah, we are repaired. I've got the naval AI card on there, so let's click on the Tasty Delight. Not my fortress. Don't click on your fortress, Matt. The Tasty Delight. Okay. I'm gonna pull all. Speed it up. Okay, so this guy's not moving anywhere. Okay, here we go. I'm going to cut this part out. So once the Tasty Delight is closer over here, we will reconvene. So I'll see you guys in just a bit. All right, guys, I'm back. It looks like we have an encounter coming up. So I had some like old dead ship scraps over there, and I just moved those. I just had them retreat, and then I just deconstructed them. They were each like one block. Oh, shit. Shit wheels. Okay. Got a lot of stuff happening in this quadrant. Okay, so here we go. First combat. Excellent. I do love first combat. Let's see what we're working with here. Perfect. So, let's go ahead and get these missiles selected. And let's see if we can do some preemptive strikes here. Oh, they're over this way. Gotcha. That might be the fortress down yonder. Yeah, I would very much like to just... Okay, yeah. Looks like three Sea Vipers. Some of these missiles may still be able to come around and hit these guys. They're gonna try. Scoosh. Alright, not bad. Another volley. We may be able to get by with just sending these two volleys out. Let's see. Oh yeah, okay. Hmm. Oh, those look like vanguards. That's two vanguards, yeah. No wonder. They are really taking a beating. Oh, I can't wait to get our bigger ship out here. This is gonna be fantastic. Yeah, those guys are... They're done. They're no longer a threat. We still have to finish them off, though. Always a true shame, but I don't mind. Whoa, little crazy camera there. Go ahead and send out some more missiles. Keep them coming. There's one down. Excellent. Goodbye, Vanguard. Now it's just this guy, and he has a solid grip coming at him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Go ahead and send these next four missiles. Get there. Let's see some explosions. There's one. Oh, there it is. And that's it. That's them. That force is now gone. All right, we took care of that pretty damn quick. Here's our Tasty Delight. You can see we only made it about one quadrant over. Still trying to make his way. So let's now get this guy. Coming out here. Yeah. Okay, here we go. 10x. I'm not going to fast forward this part. I think, we're about to have a battle here. This will be a little bit tougher. Force count 3. Strength 18. I know I've got good range on these missile boats compared to their artillery. And they're going to be over here somewhere. Looks like my guy was still doing some repairs on something. So let's see what we're dealing with here. Please don't be a river home. Please don't be... Uh-oh, looks like a Vanguard prototype. He's already shooting. Yep, he's already shooting, but I may have messed up his gun a good bit there. Those Vanguard prototypes are pretty tough. They are pretty tough. Oh, did we get the missile that's stuck in the water? No? We're definitely hitting them. So this is a fleet of all Vanguards. This is a pretty tough fleet. Alright, let's keep them coming. I'm gonna shoot a little bit to the right. I really want to hit that prototype Vanguard first. See, he's already shooting at me. Oh yeah, all of them are going over there. That's what we wanted right there. That, I just saw like his right movement paddle fully eject off there. And real quick here, let me change my external camera speed. Great. Missiles away. They should come like flying by us. Yeah, there they are. Wreck 'em. Yeah, there it is. There it is. Ah, it feels right. And then this guy. A few more coming at him. All right. Let's see. A few missiles that way. A few missiles this way. Keep shooting them. Great. Here they come. I really love that one turn thing. That really helps to just move your camera. There's another one down. Okay, this missile boat didn't do so bad. I didn't, like, futz it up like I did with that last battle in that last episode. My God. There he goes. Okay. Yes. God, that feels good after getting defeated. Screw you. Deepwater Guard hates me now. At war, negative 70. All right. Another success. Okay, guys. So I'm going to cut again because I want to get one battle with the Tasty Delight. And I'll come back when we are looking like we're over here. So I'll see you in just a bit. All right, guys, we are back. For you, that was probably near instant. For me, I was waiting for probably 2-3 minutes. Obviously, the engines aren't that great because I'm noticing here, like when I select the Tasty Delight, top speed went out of play, 5. And then I didn't realize this. I keep forgetting this is here. It's a great way to see your top speed, how much you're gathering, force points. This is really cool. So you can see we have another force coming here. So we've got one coming from the north. Pretty good size one. Oh, this used to be strength 4. It looks like they must have reinforced up here and only sent a few of them. This guy's now going to be dealing with... Oh, this is going to be great. Let's see what this says. Mobilize to defend location. Okay. Here we go. Let's get into range. I wonder if you can increase the range at which you can engage enemies. Oh my god, I'm so excited right now. Get to test this bad boy out. Alright, AI off. I'm just gonna shoot a volley this way and see what happens. Oh shit, yes. Oh, come on baby, reach these guys. Reach them. I don't think my back missiles can. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, he's getting hammered. Oh, man, is he getting hammered. Oh, and he's done. Oh, my God. Okay, that was crazy excellent. That was crazy freaking excellent. Let's get rid of this guy now. All right, I'm just aiming at it. My missiles are dropping. We got 7 left in the salvo. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Any moment now. Do-do-do-do-do. Yep, oh. Yeah, didn't have a chance. Look, here they come. Douche, douche, douche. Oh, just freaking. My God. Oh, my God. Yes, I love it. And here we are, just chilling in our own little beast here. Already halfway reloaded, which is great. So let's crank it. Let's crank the speed. Let's get out a little bit. And, you know, do you still get the XP? Like, if you pull your ship and go out of play, do you still get all of that, I wonder? I like it. It's very tasty. I can just watch my XP going up. Not by much. Okay, so here we go. Let's go this last little bit. Let's just finish this guy off. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this thing is fantastic. Obviously, it hasn't had much of a force coming at it. Like, here's a huge one right now. Or at least much bigger than the average. Alright. So, our enemy is this way. Let's see how our missiles do at an odd turn. Firing. This fortress is just a sitting duck. Oh, I am excited for this. Here they come. You can see them. Okay, so the ones that just fell, that was the back batch. They have two fuel tanks. Okay, so I'm going to have to go forward a little bit more. The missiles are running out of fuel right as they get here. They're slowly making their way in, though. They just chopped off one of the octopus arms. So, all right, let's crank it. Here we go. I need some sweet boat music when I do this. Just sailing on the open seas. Doomed. I like that we have a lot of resources now. Crystal growth is up. So at some point I should just try to create like a super beast. I want to make something that flies as well. Some sort of flying shenanigalistic amazing contraption of greatness. That's my thought. Okay, so why are there explosions to the left there? I don't know if you just saw that. It's kind of bothersome. Fire! Just kidding, my keyboard stopped responding. Gotta plug it back in. That sound may have been recorded, I don't know. I love my keyboard. Fire! Excellent. Coming in. Yeah, now we're solidly hitting this guy. Oh my gosh, we are... Oh, this is fantastic! He is getting so torn to bits! And look at his back gun. It's got no chance. And I've already launched another volley. Here they come. Just getting all up in there. He's about to just... Yeah, he's gone. He's disintegrating. And that is that. So, wow. That feels effective. That is much more effective. We've got this other force coming up right now. Oh my god, this episode's going to be running so long. It's going to take me 16 years to put this out. To upload it, I mean, and render it. That's okay. I want to fight this last force. You know? Or will this one be the one I fight? You know what? I'm going to save both these for the next episode. The next episode, we'll just hit the ground running with some combat right off the bat. So, guys, thanks for joining me. Like if you enjoyed the episode. Subscribe. I always love more subscribers. Lets me know you guys are interested. So, yeah, if you have any feedback or comments, feel free to drop me a line. A few people have already, and it's been super helpful, especially with learning this game. So, until next time, you guys stay classy, and I'll talk to you later.